Welcome to Xiting Xpert. My name is Alessandro Abanzer, and today I want to show you how we can create and compare versions of authorization data in PFCG. PFCG does not offer a revert or back button, which allows you to undo your changes in case you made a mistake. With the role versioning functionality, which was introduced with SAP NetWeaver 7.31, you can now compare and see changes to your authorization data. PFCG automatically creates a version each time you save the authorization data. A dedicated report allows you to see the details of the authorization data for every version, as well as compare two versions with each another. Let's jump right into the system to see versioning in action. Okay, so here we're now in PFCG. I open up a single role. We can see that that single role has one transaction assigned, that's SU01. SU01 brings in a couple of authorization values, and I'm now about to change just one of the authorization values and to see, you know, how a version will be created automatically. So I'm going here to the authorizations tab and, you know, going to the change mode of the authorizations. I'm, you know, trying to change an authorization value here. Let's just, you know, for an example here, let's just change S user group. And we can see here, there's a couple of activities already proposed and there's also two values. And now let's just add a third value. Let's just authorize user group super here as well. So we just change here the values. I just type it in here, super, I save. And now if I hit the save button, what will happen now is that PFCG automatically creates a version of the authorization data that I can see here. So every time a role admin changes the role, the authorization data of a role and hits the save button, it will automatically create a version. We can check the versions, there's a report, but we can also go directly from here through the menu. We go from more, utilities, and then versions. In here, we'll start that report, and we can see that that role that I'm looking at right now has six different versions. And like I said before, we can go back and see what was a version before, what's the version now, and we can also compare. So first off, let's just look into version one. We select the row here, and then we click here on display details. And now that will show me, you know, which version I'm looking at and from, you know, which date and what time it was saved. And I can see here, for example, my S user group was saved with the two user groups that we just seen before and the one that I changed. If I go back and I look the same thing, I select version 6, which is my latest version, do the same thing, look into the details. I now can see here that, you know, my super that I added is here. Even better, if I go back again, we can now compare. So let's compare version 6 with version 1. I basically just select the two rows I wanna compare, and then I hit the compare button. So I click here on compare, and what it will show me now is up here, it will show me we're comparing version 1 against version 6. The report looks fairly similar to what we've seen before. We can see here, if you hover the headers, we can see it says activation status of version 1 versus then over here, it says activation status of version 6. So we're on the left side, we see the version 1, and on the right side, we see version 6 in this example here. And then very important is the value comparison column, because this column now shows where do we have identical data and where do we have a change. So here we can see they're all identical. If I scroll down to my S user group where we changed the user group field name class, we can see in version 1 we had value X demo and X user versus now we also have that value super. So here I can, on a value level, compare what has been changed or what was changed in the role. Unfortunately, we cannot, there's no revert functionality yet in that report, so we can only compare, we cannot go back. So that's still a manual effort. If you want to revert back a change, we would have to go into the authorization data and change whatever we wanted to change. That was today's expert tip on how we can create and compare versions of authorization data in PFCG. If you want to learn more about versioning, please check out the sub notes shown here. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our newsletter to stay up to date with our expert tips. Thank you for watching and see you next time.